Hello friends, welcome back to our tutorial, Designing an Impressive Architectural Building in Revit 2018 Imperial. If you have been following along, go and open the file 00_001_DIAB_I where you save it. Go and click the file tab, save as projects. Rename this file to 00_002_DIAB_I and click the save button. In today's tutorial, we're going to draw reference plan for our projects. First, before we do, we have some hidden elements at the central of the graphic zone. To reveal this object, click on the Reveal Hide Hidden Elements. Now you see them in a purple color. If I select this element, then click the filter button. You see the project base point and the survey point. The survey point is the origin of the survey from the site. The project base point is like the UCS origin in AutoCAD. Now uncheck the survey point and click OK. Now only the project base point is selected. Go to the Reveal Hidden Element tab and click on Hide Category. In the Reveal Hidden Element tab, click the toggle Reveal Hidden Element mode to close the block. Now this button is displayed into the project, the central of the project. These are the elevation of the project. For example, this is the south elevation. If you hover the mouse cursor, it will show the names of the view. This is the east elevation, and this is the west elevation, and so on. Now go to the architectural tab, work plan panel, and select the reference plan. Zoom in into this area and start to the center of this project base point. To draw a vertical line across the project base point, now you need to extend the line. You need to move the line to extend it at the extreme end of the extreme top of the view. Click the bubble, the circle, the open circle, and move this up. Zoom in closer and click on the circle to move the reference plane down. Now start another reference plane at the center of this base point. Zoom out by rolling the mouse wheel backward and move to the extreme right. Now zoom in closely to where you start the reference plane and click this open circle. Extend to the left. Zoom by rolling the mouse wheel backward and extend the line to the extreme end. Now press escape twice to get out of the command. I want my elevation to be at the center point of the reference line. That way I know that my elevation is center to the base point. So select this and use the move command to position it at approximately the align the center of this view to the reference plane. You can use your arrow key on your keyboard to notch the view. You don't need to be exact. Select this other view and move it to align it with the reference plane. Select this view and align it to the reference plane. Select this view, align this view to the, use the right arrow key to nudge the view to the right location. Now we need to draw more reference plane. Right click this reference plane and select grid similar. Go to draw panel and select the pick line button. In the option bar, change the offset to 24 feet 10 inches. How do you enter 24 feet 10 inches in Revit? In Revit, when you are in Imperial, any unit that you enter with no symbol, Revit interprets it to be feet. If you want to enter inches, you have two options. you can enter the figure and type the double quote symbol, or you enter the figure, you enter zero for the feet and space, then the figure. Now move the mouse cursor to the screen and offset this reference plane up and offset it down. Go to the option bar and change the offset distance to 22 space 8 space 1/8 for 22 feet. It's 1/8 inches. Now select the vertical line and offset it to the left. Select and offset it to the right. Press escape to get out of the command. Select the reference plan again. Click and drag to position it to the end of this. Select this reference plane and click on this open arc circle to move it. Select this and move it. Now we need to add the project base point again. To add this base point, right, select this base point, go to the view panel and click the down arrow after hide in view and select hide category. Right click the reference plane, create similar, and select in the drop panel, select the pick line button, change your offset distance to 4 feet 6 1/4, and offset this reference plane up. Change the offset distance to 4 feet 9 1/2. Offset this line to the right. Now click the modify button. Now right click this reference plane and select grid similar. Select the pick line button and change your offset to 3 inches. Select zoom in close and pick this line to offset it up. Change the offset to 12 feet 6. Offset this line up. Change your offset distance to 8 feet. And offset this line up. Change the distance to 10 feet 6. Offset this line up. Change the offset distance to 9 feet and pan down. Offset this line up. Change the offset distance to 16 feet 6. And offset this line back down. Change the offset distance to 19 feet 6 and offset this line down. Press escape twice to get out of the command. Now right click this reference plane, create similar, select the pick line button and change the offset distance to 3 inches. Offset, zoom in and offset this line to the right. Change the offset distance to 17 feet. Offset this line to the right. Change the offset distance to 16 feet 6. Zoom out and offset this distance to the, offset this reference plane to the right. Change the offset distance to 20 feet 6 and offset this reference plane to the right. Click the modify button. Now that we have drawn some reference plan, let's select the central reference plan. select the horizontal one, hold down the control key and select the vertical reference plane. Go to the modify panel and click the pin button to pin them. When you pin a reference plane, this will prevent you to move them accidentally. Alright, we're going to stop this video here. In the next video, we'll start to draw the wall to our reference plane. If you find this tutorial useful, please click the like button and share it to your friends. If you have any question, please leave a comment below. If you want to continue this tutorial or any other tutorial on my channel, please subscribe. Thanks very much for watching. I hope to see you in the next class. Goodbye.